Hello, this is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Unity tutorial. Today we're installing Unity3D and taking a look at the differences between the free and pro version. So let's get started. Head to Google, search Unity and it should be the first link. Click the Get Unity 5 button and you'll see a comparison between Unity Free and Professional. Let's compare them, Ace. It used to be that certain features were only available in the pro version, such as nav mesh pathfinding and render textures. But now both editors are equal in terms of features. Both are royalty free, so unlike Unreal Engine, you won't be charged a percentage on your sales. You're not allowed to use the Unity free version, iOS and Android add-ons if you've earned more than $100,000 in revenue or funding in the last financial year. Games made with Unity free will have the Unity splash screen placed at the start. This is what it looks like, guys. With the pro version, you can remove the screen. The Unity Cloud build seems pretty cool, Ace. You get 12 months free of the Pro version with Unity Pro. It allows you to build your projects on the cloud and install them on your team's computers, iOS and Android devices. It's not necessary when you're just starting out, Ace, but with a bigger team and larger projects, this could be pretty useful. You can sign up to the Pro version for $25 with the free version of Unity. Or you could use the free version of the Unity Cloud. This is out of the scope of this video, Ace, but check out the link in the description for more info on this. Unity Analytics Pro can give you info about how players are interacting within your game. It's included with Unity Pro and is $25 with Unity Free. However, you can sign up to the beta for free using the link in the description, Ace. The team license consists of an asset and cache server. The cache server is pretty good as it speeds up import time when you switch platforms and big projects. The asset server is Unity's own version control and is inferior to more popular version control software in my opinion, Ace. I'll be showing you how to set up the one I use in a later video. The prioritized bug handling seems like a poor benefit, Ace. A bug is a bug, and if it's present on the free version, chances are it'll be there in the pro version as well. The game performance reporting tracks and reports exceptions in your game with a pretty nice user interface. I've never used it, Ace, and have survived without it. Beta access. I really don't agree with this one, Ace. A beta is a pre-release of a piece of software and is usually a bit unstable with some hard to track down bugs. Getting the community to use beta benefits the community since we all get to see the new software features and benefits the company since they get their software tested for free. Having this exclusive to pro only members limits that testing. Unlimited revenue and funding is more or less a repeat of the all platforms point. Earn more than $100,000, upgrade to pro. Simple as that, Ace. I'm not too sure what future platforms means, Ace. Personally, I think this is more of a filler point. The professional editor skin is a darker version of the free editor skin. I was actually surprised by how many developers were in uproar about this point, Ace. This is what the pro skin looks like. And here's the free skin. Asset store level 11. Spend money to potentially save money, Ace. This will offer you discounts on certain assets at different times, so you might save money in the long run. Professional community features is another one I don't agree with, Ace. The Unity community is great and offers a wide variety of solutions for different problems. Since both editors are the same, it seems a little pointless to have threads reserved for pro-only members. Anyone who has a problem should post on the public thread, since you'll get a bigger audience. You can pay for source code access as well, Ace, but you'll have to contact Unity's sales team. You can also pay for premium support with either version. Out of all these differences, Ace, I would say the only things I'd be tempted by are the Unity Cloud building, the customized splash screen, and the cache server with a team license. But for a small mobile game, the only real necessity is the customizable splash screen. If you want to be really sneaky, Ace, you could use the free version for your entire development, so long as you haven't passed the $100,000 limit. Then when you're ready, pay for a month of Unity Pro, build, release your game, and cancel your subscription. Now, Unity is an outstanding service, Ace, so I can't in all good conscience advise you to do this, but there doesn't seem to be anything stopping you from doing so. Let's download Unity. Click the free download button, and when the page loads up, click the download installer button. Once it's finished, launch the download assistant. Click next. Check the accept box and keep clicking next, Ace. If you're like me and have terrible internet connection, it may take some time to download and install. Once it's done, feel free to launch Unity, Ace. You may also want to pin Unity to your taskbar and delete the desktop shortcut. Click the new project button, name your project and save it to wherever you like, Ace. Once you've done that, click create project and Unity should open in all its free skin brilliance. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Any feedback you can give is greatly appreciated. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with whatever you like, Ace. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.